To help us make sense of today's market movements, we're now joined by Christina Ulang. She's the head of research of the First Metro Hello. Investment Corporation. Good to have you again, Christina.
Hi, Stanley. Good afternoon. Thanks for having me.
Okay, now first day of the fourth week of trading at a loss. Have we entered the bearish territory? And is this the end of the January rally, so to speak? What do you think?
Hi, clearly it's the end. End of the rally last January. We're entering February with weakness. There's foreign selling, very much in contrast with January, which was unusually historically a seasonally strong period. We had net foreign buying in January, and then we also had a rally in the debt markets, the cost of money and the T-bills and T-bonds have rallied. That was in January, but now we're seeing interest rates increases, and that was a result of the BSP hiking the rate by an aggressive 50 basis point. And so the 10-year is moving up and may reach like 6.5%, and it's negative for the equities market. That's why we're seeing a correction in the equities market. But there could be some relief rally when the market sees the February inflation. So the market's going to be very data dependent. What's going to be February inflation? Maybe there's going to be a tapering because the imports of vegetables have come in, and the lag effects of the oil price drops in the last weeks of January can manifest its lag effects in the month of February, and also the lag effect of the peso strength. In recent weeks, like when it approached 53, could be manifest in the February inflation. So February inflation may show an improvement from the very high 8.7%, and that could give the market some relief rally.
Okay, let's go back to the markets now. A lot of analysts are saying 67.50 is said to be a very critical support. Unfortunately, it was breached today at 67.44. Now, maybe a lot of investors are asking what's a good level to buy the market again. Because, Christina, as we've noticed, the market was hitting 7,000 to 7,100 and going back to 6,700. But still, a lot of index stocks remain expensive. They're not cheap.
Yeah, because investors are very selective now, and you'll see that the top gainers are mostly conglomerates. And right. Just because the market is down doesn't mean some stocks are going to be down. So that means there are inherent growth stories within the specific companies, and that rallies are really company specific. If a company has a story to tell and able to show that it can weather the challenges of the times, like higher cost of doing business, higher interest rates, and if it has a commanding market share, then and cheap valuation, then it's a good stock pick. So investments, investors are doing just that, picking the best among the best.
Okay, now let's talk about the Bloomberg interview with BSP Governor Felipe Medalli. He was ruling out a 70 bips increase, but of course the BSP has been hinting at least three more rate hike adjustments of 25 to 50 bips in its succeeding meetings. Is the market pricing this in as a positive development, considering that the past hikes did very little to ease inflation?
There's a lot of uncertainty, actually. So the market cannot really fully price in all of the things that are the moving parts of the macro economy. The inflation now is very unpredictable. If we are going to have a storm now, then the inflation rate is going to be a lot different again if we have a benign weather. So we're very much vulnerable to climate change. That's one. Right. And then to the geopolitical tension, the impact on the supply chains. Right now, there's a lot of negative news in the geopolitical front, heightening risk between China and the U.S., and then these missiles being fired by North Korea, and the spy balloons.
Yeah.
So many geopolitical risks affecting risk on, going back to risk off, and so it's really hard to predict what's going to happen. But I think the central bank is sending a very strong signal to the market that it's not it is really serious in fighting inflation, and that it has to be a 50 basis point to show the aggressiveness and not 25. And if there's going to be more rate hikes, that just shows that the policymakers are very proactive and really in a very serious fight versus a very sticky and stubborn inflation.
Okay, lastly, Christina, we've of course seen inflation uncontrollable in the Philippines. A lot of economists are saying it is not just about monetary policy, but the government has to have its own counterpart, non-monetary measures. Now, are you confident that government's non-monetary interventions can alleviate the price increases? For one, President Marcos is now talking about establishing an interagency team to find ways to prevent spikes in, of course, the prices of goods and services. Do you think this will work immediately?
There's always a short run and a long run. And if there's an agency task force, I'm sure they're going to be both looking at the short run. And the short run requires temporary measures that are not meant to become permanent. And the temporary measures could be like checking what's wrong with the supply chain, if there is price manipulation, what's happening with the market dynamics, supply and demand, and if imports can help temporarily, maybe we can do more importation. And the recent extension of the tariffs on meat and chicken is a good development. Mm-hmm. It helps temporarily, but making it permanent is going to be negative for our local producers. And so the long run should be requiring some measures addressing our infrastructure. The interagency task force maybe can look at how to make our agri-related infrastructure more climate resilient. And so we are able to enjoy still low vegetables and food prices, even though there's climate action, negative adverse climate events. That's one. And then second, it is important that we make agriculture profitable and we incentivize farmers through technology transfer and then organizing them into cooperatives that are really able to move and to become effective when it comes to acquiring the technology that they need and the financing and the insurance, the crop insurance that they need every time there are damages coming from climate events. Right.
All right, Christina Ulang, it's always good to have you on the show. Have a pleasant day.
Sure, thank you. Bye-bye.